afternoon, everybody. What is going on? If you did not read the title, I'm sure you've guessed it by now, what we're about to talk about today. And it is another Green Room 136 product. This time, we're taking a quick look and a review of the Metro Drifter. This is a relatively new offering from Green Room, and I was actually in the middle of working on the Bootstrap and the Junk Monkey review when Patrick reached out to me and said, I got a little surprise headed your way. Check it out. Let me know what you think. And I will, I'm gonna tell you, I like what I'm seeing here. So we're gonna try to do this off the cuff. I've prepared no script, no nothing. We're gonna go ahead and talk about this because I'm excited about this little bag. It's a little guy, but it packs a powerful punch. Now to start, we'll hit up a few of these features. It does come with an removable shoulder strap here. You pretty much have three points where you can remove it, and it also helps for adjustment because you can kind of lock the strap into place if you need to tighten it or loosen it. You can actually lock the strap in there, so it's gonna help it from sliding around and getting too long or too short on you. On the outside of the bag, on both sides, we do have a little bit of Molly webbing, which comes in perfect for things like a Manfrotto tripod. And once we pop open our flap, we can already see we have our standard fold-over flap here to keep the contents of the bag dry. Across the front, we have a bit of a three-dimensional zipper pocket. And inside, across the front of the bag, we actually have two slit pockets. And then we also have what is a little bit of a padded tablet sleeve that runs across the back. But we also have two little, can't really see them, two little side pockets on either side of this bag. Now these two little side pockets I actually love. I can stick little things in there that I didn't even think about before that can give me a little bit more organization. I can reach in, I can grab them, use what I need, put it back, and go. And this bag is it's perfect for on the go because that's exactly what this bag is made for. Now, to show you what I've really been carrying, I've been using this Suray cell phone lens kit. So that's always on me no matter what bag I'm taking. Of course, my Thrasher magazine, which fits, does not fit in the tablet pocket. The tablet pocket is a little too small. It just doesn't fit, but it'll sit right across the back and the top folds over perfect. And can't leave home without your little tech pocket here. Inside here, I've got a couple of different wires and cables and a battery bank for charging things like cell phones, camera batteries, all those odds and ends. Never leave home without a small tech pouch with at least a cell phone cable for the phone that you use and a battery bank. These are a lifesaver, especially if you travel a lot. So all of these fit nicely in here, and my Canon G7X actually fits in here perfect too. It's I'm not using it right now. I honestly don't know where it is. It's someplace in a pile of gear or in a camera bag. It exists, I just don't know where it is, so I couldn't grab it to show you, but I put all of that in here and it easily fits in this bag. No problem, sling it, big bench, and I'm good to go. Now, I only really have one negative with this bag. As you can see, is a single shoulder strap bag. And generally, they come with a cross strap that helps keep them in place. But because this is such an easy on-the-go bag and it's so small, you don't really need one with it. But if you wear a leather jacket, it slides around on your back a little bit. And that's honestly really it. I did use this bag way more than I thought I would use it. It's like the perfect size bag for everything that I need to bring to work if I'm not bringing a camera or anything, and it fits my cell phone lens kit that I've been carrying with me for probably close to 2 months now or so. And that's, it's not big, but it's not small, so it fits in here perfectly. Still have plenty of space. I usually keep things, I'll throw like a can of water in here to take to work along with my Canon G7X that was normally in here. Got my battery bank, always got a magazine. I usually also have a notebook in here, a Sharpie, a pen and a pencil. Pen, pencil, Sharpie, they don't take up much space, but the notebook fits in here no problem with the magazine and everything else. And this thing is great. I actually scaled down what I was carrying just so I can carry this bag more because it was just so perfect. I could fit everything I need without carrying all the extra junk. And we've had a couple really, really hot days. I'm talking 90 plus here Fahrenheit. So I didn't really want to have a bigger bag on my back because
when you're driving on a scooter in direct sunlight and you're stopped at a traffic light, the last thing you want is a large bag on your back making you sweat more.
Especially if you're on your way to work. So this was like the perfect bag for that massive heat wave that hit us. And yeah, I actually love this bag. Speaking of a heat wave, I found one use for this bag that I'm not sure if Green Room had thought about, but it came in super handy on two different shoots that I did for work. Because I was filming for work, I was busy filming for work, so my focus was work and not filming B-roll for the review. So here is a dramatic reenactment of the nifty little way I was using this bag on two shoots in 90 plus degree weather. Now my normal work camera bag is a Lowepro Protactic 450 AW Generation 1. It's a pretty big bag. So when it was that hot, I didn't want to have that on my back. I didn't need everything in it. Just need my batteries, maybe an ND filter, something like that.
So me having my Metro Drifter with me that first day of shooting was a godsend.
We were getting ready and I looked at the bag and I just thought, oh my God, I don't want to carry this. It's so hot. I'm going to be bending over. I'm going to be running around. I don't want to have this big backpack on my back just to carry some batteries and a filter. Oh, because I needed camera batteries, I needed gimbal batteries, I needed ND filters. I do have more lenses, but I didn't need those right then and there that I could run back to the car for. So I looked down and I had my Metro Drifter there. I adjusted it a little bit, threw it around my waist, tossed everything I needed in this bag, and then I more or less wore it as a fanny pack. And I didn't have to, I was still hot. You can't get around the fact that it was 90 plus degrees out, but I didn't have to carry a massive camera bag and just become a puddle. I was able to strap this around me and oh my God, this was such a lifesaver. So when I had a shoot 2 days later in pretty much the same temperature, I did the exact same thing with this and it was, oh my God, it was so much better to just have this little pouch on me that I could just swing around, get what I needed, put it back, toss the batteries in. Wow, so much more comfortable wearing this than the massive camera bag. So if you're a professional shooter and you just want like a little hip pouch or something, your Metro Drifter is going to be a surprisingly good option, especially with all of that little internal organization in there, live batteries, dead batteries, ND filters. You want to carry a tablet or a mini monitor that you could strap. Everything you need that you can just kind of toss in here and go, minus you know, the camera and the tripod, but this fit everything I needed to run around in circles all day long filming. This was great.
Moving on.
I've been using this bag now for over a month, and like I said, I use this way more than I actually anticipated using it. The pros of this bag, it is super, super comfortable. If you're not wearing a smooth leather jacket, like something like a t-shirt or like a denim jacket or denim vest, it does, you know, move around a little bit because there's no cross strap, but it doesn't slide around like it did on a smooth leather jacket. But if you're not commuting on a scooter or motorcycle, you're probably not gonna be wearing a leather jacket, so you don't really have to worry about that. This Molly webbing here was a godsend to stick that Manfrotto tripod in. When I was using my Canon G7X, I filmed a section of the Suray cell phone lens kit review with this bag. Everything I needed to film that review, minus the camera and tripod I needed to film me filming, fit in this bag. That was a Suray kit, that was the cell phone
There's a cell phone case that came with it and then a lens that clips on the cell phone case. So I had the actual lens kit plus the lens that came with the cell phone case. I had my battery bank in here because I was using my cell phone a lot. Then I had the Canon G7X in here and the Manfrotto tripod in here so I can film some of the shots of the actual cell phone and the lenses that I was using. So this thing fit everything I needed, and I probably still could have fit like a water in here to drink because it was, again, ungodly hot. It's still ungodly hot. It's still 83 degrees outside Fahrenheit right now, and it's a little bit later on in the day. So this thing is great. Now, would I tell you to buy this? I think at this point you know where I'm going. Yes, you should definitely buy this bag. If you just need a small commuter bag, if you just need a small bag to go into the city, this bag is great. It's a little bit smaller than the Metro Monger, which is a little bit bigger. It does have the cross strap. It's got a little more tech involved in the bag, but for something very simple that you don't need to carry a lot, or you're trying to scale down what you carry by carrying a smaller bag, which is what I did, this is definitely the bag for you. I love that the strap it's padded, has that air mesh on the back so it was comfortable to wear. It's adjustable if I want to make the bag longer, I want to make the bag shorter. You just unhook and loop the sections and you can adjust the strap accordingly. It does have two little plastic D-rings here on either side, so you could potentially even rig up a cross strap on here if you wanted to have like the sternum strap. It's great, it's durable, it fit way more than I thought it would fit, and it fit everything I need, and it surprised me with the being able to wear it as a fanny pack to throw all my odds and ends for that shoot. So, any Green Room product that you're thinking about buying, any single Green Room 136 product that you're looking at right now, you're probably looking at a lot of them because they have a lot of stuff on that website, a lot of customizable stuff. Their wildcard custom stuff is amazing. You really cannot go wrong with anything from Green Room 136. Green Room 136. Green Room 136. The Metro Drifter, love this bag. I'm gonna keep using it. I'm probably gonna use it tomorrow because I don't need to bring a whole lot with me to work. And I'll be out filming all day, so instead of carrying my LowPro all day long, I'm probably gonna just throw what I need in this thing and take this with me to film in and around all the different buildings at work tomorrow. So hop online, go to Green Room 136, get some gear. You will not be disappointed. I promise you, their stuff is golden. You will love it. If you like this video or any of my other videos, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Smash that big red button and ring that bell so you get notifications next time I post a brand new video.